Now, imagine all of a sudden, the biggest country in the world, Russia, just disappeared. Oh my god, the world is gonna be so much different. What about Japan? What about North Korea? What about the whole of Africa? That's exactly what we're gonna discuss about today. Let's just get right into it. Now, let's just think that Russia's territory just became uninhabited. Well, believe it or not, Russia actually saved Europe on various occasions. For instance, Russia was the country that blocked the Turks in Eastern Europe, and without Russia, most of the countries today in Eastern Europe, which are these countries, would be at risk of not existing and just being a part of Turkey. Without Russia, the territory of Siberia would be lost to China, and hence China could be a neighbor of Georgia, for instance. Okay, enough history. Russia just disappeared in the air. Boom. It's gone. That would boost the ocean coverage of the Earth to 82% from what is today 71%. Hence, that will lower the surface of all of the world's oceans. That is important. 144 million people are gone. Russian language is also gone, and it would make other languages not even exist, such as Belarusian, Ukrainian, Kazakh, or Kyrgyz. Belarus, Kazakhstan, and Mongolia suddenly become great maritime nations and not landlocked anymore. China gets new direct routes in Europe. That would make China have an insane economy. If Russia didn't exist, chemistry would be easier since there wouldn't be the periodic table of elements by Mendeleev. Artificial satellites would be much more delayed, probably not even exist today. And that would make weather forecasting a torment, like you wouldn't know when it will rain and stuff. GPS would be a problem, and my channel would be a problem, as most of the facts are based on scientific research. Tetris and AK-47 wouldn't exist neither, and Mozambique will definitely have a different flag. Now France is gone. If France disappeared, Switzerland wouldn't be a landlocked country, but instead have access to the Atlantic Ocean. Same goes for Luxembourg. These countries could have an important role in the worldwide trade. Back to history. Without France, England would have remained an Anglo-Saxon nation. England would have become more like Norway or Sweden and not have that big of an influence. The English language wouldn't be the main language of the world. But bro, we're talking about France, not England. Iberia would become an island instead of a peninsula. This will make most of the population of Spain travel to Africa instead of Europe. So tourism will certainly take a big hit in Europe, as the most visited country is gone. Monaco would become an island just like Nauru, for instance. Without France, we could say goodbye to champagne, baguette, croissant, pencil sharpener, Eiffel Tower, and French colonialism of 72 countries. This would make countries like Congo, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Senegal, Chad change their main language. Napoleon wouldn't exist. Same goes for Victor Hugo or Kylian Mbappe. French Guiana wouldn't exist and probably just be Guyana. Polynesia would be independent. Without France, the European Union wouldn't even have been formed, since France was one of the founding members and has played a significant role in its development. Now, let's just go to the other side of the world, and we have Canada. So, you know, Canada has approximately 900,000 lakes. Well, let's just imagine all of those lakes just flooded the whole of Canada. Well, yeah, the lakes will disappear, and half of the world's freshwater supplies would also vanish. That is really, really bad. The second biggest country, gone. A good percentage of the world's high-grade uranium would also vanish. Snowmobiles wouldn't exist. And African people gotta thank Canada for discovering the Ebola vaccine, which saved a lot of lives in Africa. Niagara Falls, gone. Other inventions such as the garbage bag, which is so important nowadays, the peanut butter, yeah, road lines, and even the Java programming language wouldn't exist. So apps like Netflix, Spotify, Uber, Amazon, and most importantly, Minecraft, would either not exist or be very, very different. Now, we're gonna look at Japan. So, Japan, boom, is gone. Did you even realize it? So, we can say goodbye to anime, emojis, and sumo. Karaoke, blue LEDs, and most importantly, QR codes wouldn't exist today. Without QR codes, you'll probably spend years at an airport or at a stadium just to get in. The new most populated city in the world would become Delhi. Oh yeah, and without Japan, World War II would be very different, and the USA wouldn't even be implicated in it. Nintendo, Mario, Pokemon, PlayStations, Sonic, they're all gone as well. So many insane games will just disappear. China would actually get more natural disasters since Japan is like a tsunami barrier for China. So that's a disadvantage for China. The life expectancy average would certainly go down, and according to my math, it would become 72.4 years old, slightly lower than today's average life expectancy. Now we're gonna look at an interesting one, North Korea. So, if Kim Jong-un disappeared, people will have freedom again. They can use any haircuts they want, they wouldn't need to pay for desks at school, they could wear any jeans at any times. The Korean Peninsula would be reunified. This would be a major step towards peace and stability in the region. So people wouldn't want to escape the country anymore. North Korea's nuclear weapons would be in the hands of USA, adding an additional 50 nuclear weapons to their arsenal. Now USA would have a total of 5,600 nuclear weapons. North Koreans would have access to internet again, so they can meme about Kim Jong-un. Finally, bro. USA wouldn't have to worry about North Korea's nuclear weapons, but instead take care of other problems like the Sudan war. Overall, the world will become a safer place, and overall a major victory for democracy. And we're gonna end up with Africa. I couldn't really find any info about any African country, so I just decided to do all of Africa at once. Yeah, it's not a country, but we can just suppose it is. We'll never see 1.2 billion people ever again. The second largest continent on Earth will disappear, and that will create a massive tsunami and chaos in the world. Actually, humanity wouldn't even exist, as the first humans ever originated in Africa, and that's where it all started. Pyramids? Gone. The longest river would be the Amazon River. The largest desert besides Antarctica would be the Arabian Desert. Native animals to Africa, like zebra, ostrich, giraffe, would drown and disappear. Hippos could be chilling in Saudi Arabia, Australia, or Brazil, depending on the route that they choose. The earth would become more contaminated, with less oxygen level, so let's thank the trees in Africa for what they do every single day. Without Africa, the Mediterranean Sea wouldn't exist. This will make a lot of European nations suddenly have access to the ocean, and they could deliver goods easier to India, for instance, which is a very big consumer. The earth would become much more expensive and with less stocks. Diamonds, coal will take a big hit and the prices will just skyrocket. Okay guys, you spammed me once again that I did a stupid mistake, and I was thinking that Elon Musk was from USA. No, he's from South Africa. So if there wasn't Africa, that means Elon Musk wouldn't exist. So there wouldn't be Tesla, SpaceX, and Twitter will be in good hands once again. Other goats like Didier Drogba or Sadio Mane will just be swimming in the Atlantic Ocean, and Liverpool will continue to suffer. I don't even think we're gonna have four oceans, but three instead. The Indian Ocean and the Atlantic Ocean would just unite and form a new ocean called Indo-Atlantic Ocean. So yeah, I don't see the logic why we would still have four oceans. And with that, this video came to an end. One subscribe equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. We're so close to 10,000 subscribers, so if you could subscribe, that would make my day. Thank you for watching, and see ya in the next video.